Islam arrived in India within a century of its inception. In quite a substantial sense, Muslims set their foot on Indian soil before Muhammad bin Qasim arrived with his army from Arabia in 725 AD. The Muslims of India faced their greatest trauma in the wake of the partition in 1947. It was their moment of truth when the country stood divided on the basis of the two-nation theory propounded by the Muslim League under the leadership of M.A. Jinnah. India became a secular state in sharp contrast to the theocratic, newly created state of Pakistan at the dawn of independence. Indian Muslims had the advantage of guidance of stalwarts of India's national movement, notable among them, besides Maulana Azad, Rafi Ahmed Kidwai, and Dr. Zakir Hussain. The latter rose to be the president of India.
I think the Indian cinema is a symbol of secularism. And it is a symbol, why it became a symbol? It's being seen by the people of the country, and that consists of so many people belonging to different faiths. When they go and see the film, they go and see the star and the actor performing over there. They don't go in the theater that this fellow belongs to our religion and we will see his film. As you know, that Mr. Dilip Kumar, who's a Muslim, he's been considered by every Indian, whether he's a Hindu or a Muslim or a Christian or a Sikh, as a great actor. He has contributed a lot to the Indian cinema. He brought greater prestige for India, from abroad also. And through his performances, I think every Indian respects him. You know, all the top stars today, they're Muslims in India. And it's a pride for us.
If you look at the prominent people who have made a mark for themselves, people who immediately come to my mind are people like Rafi Saab, you know, in the singing, then there is K. Asif, Mehboob Saab, then there is Dilip Saab, then there's Naushad Saab in music, then there are, you know, I might be missing a few here and there, but you know, when you look at the current lot, you see the likes of Salman, Amir, Shah Rukh, and then the younger ones like Saif Ali Khan who are making an impact. And you have A.R. Rahman in your music, you've got Anu Malik. So, you know, these are the kind of people who probably immediately come to your mind who have made an impact in the film industry. And, you know, they're contributors, you know.
Practically in the writing field, I suppose, in the lyrics department, they have made a lot of contribution. We have enormously huge names in that, like Sahir Ludhianvi, Majroor Sultanpuri, Kaifi Azmi, who have made contributions to this thing.
Construction industry, aaj dekho Bombay mein hum baithe, Lokhandwala is the biggest name. He's a Muslim. Rijvi is the biggest name, he's a Muslim. So, kaam to milta hai, kaam chalte rehta hai.
Azim Premji is an ideal example of the Muslim contribution and quest to come into the mainstream and belong. Like this, for example, there's another gentleman in South India, in Vanambadi. He quotes the leather price of the world each morning. The Muslim Zardozi workers, their export is worth about 40,000 crores. So you can imagine how much contribution they are making to the exchequer by way of foreign exchange earnings.